Welcome to the bilingual e-lecture series for diploma students. Now we are going to see the mechanical properties of materials, which is covered in Unit 2 of Strength of Materials subject for second year mechanical engineering students. Now let us go to the topic. First, we will strengthen the terminologies related to the mechanical properties of materials. First term is strength. What is strength? Strength is the ability of a material to resist the externally applied forces without breaking or yielding. It is known as the strength of the material. Oru material mele apply pannakoodiye external forces nala adu failure agakoodadhu. And the property or material and the property tha enna solrom appadina strength appadini solrom. So strength is the ability of the material to resist the externally applied forces without breaking or yielding. Elasticity is the property of materials to regain its original shape after deformation when the applied force is removed. Imagine it is an object. Now I am going to apply a load. Due to the applied force, there was some deformation in the object. But when I remove the object, immediately it regains its original position. This is the starting position. This is the time after applying the force. This is the position of the object after removal of the force, when the force is removed. So the property of the material to regain its original shape when the applied force is removed is known as elasticity. Best examples are steel, rubber. Plasticity. The property of a material which enables the formation of permanent deformation without rupture due to the applied load is known as plasticity. So here, what I am going to do, I am going to take an object and I am going to apply a force on the object. Due to the applied force, there will be some permanent deformation. It is a permanent deformation. Even after the withdrawal of the applied force, the object will not regain its original position. In the property ki per enna solrom appadina plasticity. Appa plasticity na enna, or external applied force nala object oda shape size disturb agudhu without rupture, without failure. This is known as plasticity. Best examples are clay and lead. Ductility. The property of a material which enables the material to be drawn out or elongate into thin wires without rupture is known as ductility. Best examples are gold and platinum. So I am having an object. This object can be drawn out into thin wires. This property is called as ductility. Gold and platinum are exhibiting very good property of ductility property. Malleability. This is same to ductility, but here we are going to make them into thin sheets. In the ductility, we are going to make them into thin wires. Here we are going to make the materials into thin sheets. So what is malleability? Property of a material which enables it to be flattened into thin sheets without cracking by hot or cold rolling process is known as malleability. Best examples are aluminium, copper, tin. Here the output will be in the form of thin sheets. Next one is stiffness. The property of a material to resist elastic deformation or deflection is known as stiffness. You take a material, I am going to apply some force on the material. Because of the force, there must be some deformation. But this material does not permit the elastic deformation or deflection. This property is called as stiffness. Then next one is toughness and hardness. What is toughness? Toughness is the ability of a material to withstand both plastic and elastic deformations when subjected to an external force. Elastic deformation, plastic deformation, rendering withstand panna kudiye or ability irukka kudiye material ku enna solra appadina toughened material appdinu solrom. Indha property ku peru vandu toughness. Examples pathina mild steel and wrought iron are best examples for materials having good toughness property. Hardness. Hardness is the ability of the material to resist scratching, abrasion, penetration or indentation on its surface. Hardness inna enna, it is the property of the material to resist scratch. Inna eludhuram epdi scratch porumle and the scratches alla permit panna koodadhu. Abrasion, grinding wheels, abrasive grinding wheels vachu machine pandramle. Penetration or indentation, punching indha mari pandradha vande it should resist. Okay, best examples are diamond and hardened steel. Diamond and hardened steel. Next one is brittleness, the property of a material which enables it to rupture with little permanent distortion is known as brittleness. Best examples are glass and cast iron. In the material enna pannu appadina the property ulla material vande slight permanent deformation oda enna aidum rupture aayirum. You take a object, it is a material. Now I am going to apply the force apply panna odane, okay, it fails with little deformations. It fails with little deformations. It is a permanent distortion. This is known as brittleness. Best examples are glass and cast iron. Wear resistance. The ability of the material to resist wear is known as wear resistance. Case hardening and nitriding material will have this property. This is very much essential for materials which are exposed to continuous rubbing process. For example, bearing, bushes, in those cases we have to go for material which are having or which are good in wear resistance. Next one is castability. Castability is the property of a material which enable it to be cast into different size and shape is known as castability. And the material uruki different sizes layum shape layum namma enna panna mudiyum mold panni edukkudi casting panni edukkudi oru property ku peru da castability appdi solrom. Weldability, the capacity of the metal to be welded into a specific and suitable designed structure and to perform satisfactorily in the intended service is known as weldability. In the intended service is known as weldability. The capacity of the material to be welded into specific and suitably designed structure, okay, and to perform satisfactory in the intended service is known as weldability. These kind of materials can be easily subjected to welding. Fatigue. Fatigue refers to failure of material below its static breaking strength under repeated loading. I am having an object, okay, I am applying a load, the object is having good strength, so it regain its original position after the removal of the applied load. Na thirumba thirumba load apply pannikittiruken appo enna agudhu appadina at a particular point below its static breaking strength the object fails. This property is called as fatigue. Fatigue happens only because of repeated loading only. It reduces the strength of the material. It reduces the strength of the material. What is the fatigue strength? The stress at which a metal fails by fatigue is known as fatigue strength. The stress at which a metal fails by fatigue is known as fatigue strength. Next, creep. The slow and the progressive deformation of a material with the time at constant stress is called as creep. Okay, slow and progressive deformation of a material. Okay, we used to sit in wire chairs. Okay, initially the wires will be very tensed. After some time the wires will have some distortion, okay, some deformations in their positions, This is because of the slow and progressive load. So, the slow and progressive deformation of a material with respect to time at constant stress is called as creep. Then what is temperature creep? The progressive slow deformation with the time of a material subjected to a constant stress at elevated temperature, at elevated temperature below the elastic limit is called as temperature creep. At very high temperature, we are going to allow the material to be deformed slowly and progressively. This property is called as temperature creep. Then there are two types of loading. One is cyclic loading, another one is repeated loading. What is cyclic loading? If a machine is subjected to compressive and tensile stresses alternatively, and also the value of stresses vary from maximum to minimum value or vice versa at regular intervals, such a type of loading is known as cyclic loading. The cyclic loading na enna solra appadina oru machine an object is subjected to compressive and tensile load, maathi compressive load and tensile load maathi kudukrom. Adu mattum illama and the stress value vandu it varies from maximum to minimum, minimum to maximum. So tensile to alter, compressive to tensile, maximum to minimum, idu maathi kudukra load peru enna appadina cyclic loading. But it happens at regular intervals. Idu eppa nadakkudna regular intervals la nadakkudhu. What do you mean repeated loading? The applied load is repeatedly varied either in value or in value and direction. Onnu value mattum change pandrom alladhu enna pandrom value and direction change pandrom during a test. This is known as repeated loading. So the applied load is repeatedly varied either in value or both in value and direction during a test. This is known as repeated loading. Endurance limit. What is endurance limit? It is the limiting stress. It is the limiting stress below which a load can be repeatedly applied an infinitely large number of times without causing failure. This is the limiting stress below which we can repeatedly apply the load for so many times. Okay, there will be no failure. This limit is called as endurance limit. Next one is machinability. It is very, very important for mechanical engineers, isn't it? The ease with which metal can be machined by cutting tools in various machining operations is known as machinability. Cutting tools vachi enna panna porom appadina oru metal vandu machining panna porom. We are going to allow the material to be subjected to different machining operations by using cutting tools, different type of cutting tools. But the material should be easy to machine. Okay, the property of the material which makes its ease for the metal removal process during the machining operations by cutting tools is known as machinability. It is known as machinability. Now we are going to classify the four system. Okay, still now we concentrated on the important terminology related to the mechanics of materials. Now we are going to classify the four systems. What is a load? Load or force may be defined as the combined effect of external forces acting on a body. A load or force may be defined as the combined effect of external forces acting on the body. What are the types of forces? There are five types of forces: tensile force, compressive force, shear force, bending force, torsional force. What is a tensile force? When your body is subjected to equal and opposite pulls, then it is called as tensile force. When your body is subjected to two equal and opposite pulls, equal, both are equal in magnitude but acting in opposite direction. The object is subjected to two equal and opposite pulls. This is called as tensile force. What will be the result? There will be a elongation. Length will be increased. What about the diameter? Dia will be decreased because of the tensile force. Next one is the compressive force. Here we are going to replace the pulls by means of pushes. So when your body is subjected to two equal and opposite pushes, then it is called as compressive force. Okay. What is the result? The object will, length of the object will be reduced, object is shrinked. So, the diameter will increase, okay, diameter increases, but length decreases by means of this compressive force. Next one is shear force. Here, the object is fastened firmly. The axial force is applied as shown in the figure. Okay, we are going to apply an axial force P like this, we are going to apply. Now, we increase the force gradually. If we increase the value of force gradually, what will happen? The object is shear off. This force is called as shear force. In case of bolt and nut heads, we can see this. In case of bolt and nut, if we apply the forces, because of the forces, the bolt head will be released, detached from the bolt. Okay. So, this force is called as shear force. Next one is the bending force. A beam is simply supported as shown in the figure. A force is applied vertically in the beam. Now, the beam bends. Okay. Because of the applied load, the beam bends. Okay. The beam bends like this. Because of the applied force, the beam bends like this. The applied force is called as bending force. The stress developed is called as bending stress. Okay. Next one is the torsional force. What is torsional force? The shaft is subjected to two equal and opposite end couples. The axis of couple coincides with the axis of the shaft. Okay. Now, the shaft tends to twist. This force is called torsional force. The stress developed is called as torsional stress. Now, we are going to look at the important term, stress. What is stress? When a body is subjected to an external force, it undergoes some deformation as its molecules create an internal resistance to deformation. This resistance per unit area to deformation is known as stress. So, in simple, what is stress? Stress is the internal resistance offered by the material against the applied force, is called as stress. Or object mele or force apply pandrom and the force eduthu object kulla enna varudna or internal resistance produce agudhu. And the internal resistance produced per unit area, adha enna solrom appadina stress appdinu solrom. So, stress is the ratio of internal resistance divided by area. This term is called as sigma. Sigma is equal to load by area. Sigma is equal to P by A. What is the unit? Load is in Newton, A is in mm square. So, the unit is, unit of stress is Newton per mm square. Next one is strain. When a body is subjected to an external force, it undergoes deformation leading to change in dimension. Thus, strain is the ratio of change in dimension to its original dimension. Strain is given by change in dimension to original dimension. Or object la enna pandrom appadina normal ark object la or force apply pannum bolude or deformation agudhu. Appa dimension enna agudhu? Change agudhu. Appa original dimension ku change ana dimension ku original dimension ku ulla ratio enna solrom appadina strain appadinu solrom nama. Then there are two types of stresses, tensile stress and compressive stress. When a body is subjected to two equal and opposite axial pulls and the body tends to increase its length, then the stress is called as tensile stress. When a body is subjected to equal and opposite axial pull push and the body tends to shorten its length, then the stress induced is called as compressive stress. This is because of tensile force and this is because of compressive force. Already we have discussed it. Isn't it? Yes. Next one is Hooke's law. What is Hooke's law? Hooke's law states that stress is directly proportional to the strain up to elastic limit. Stress is directly proportional to strain up to the elastic limit. If you assume P is the stress and E is the strain, then stress is directly proportional to strain. This law is known as Hooke's law. Next one is Young's modulus or modulus of elasticity. Young's modulus is defined as ratio of stress to strain within the elastic limit. Stress ku strain ku mulla ratio elastic limit ulla ratio vatha enna solrom appadina Young's modulus appdi solrom. Young's modulus is given by stress by strain and its unit is Newton per meter square or Newton per mm square. What is working stress? The maximum safe stress which is allowed to be undertaken by the material in designs is called as working stress. It is called as working stress or design stress. This stress is considered for designing purposes. So, we have to concentrate on an important terminology, important term called as factor of safety FOS. Factor of safety FOS. What is factor of safety? Factor of safety is the ratio of ultimate stress to the working stress. Factor of safety is the ratio of ultimate stress to the working stress. In case of brittle material, it is ultimate stress to working stress, and in case of ductile material, it is yield stress to working stress. Okay. So, three types of terms are here. First one is factor of safety. Factor of safety is given by ultimate stress or maximum stress to working stress or safe stress. So, factor of safety can be defined as the ratio of ultimate stress to working stress or safe stress. What is ultimate stress? Ultimate stress is nothing but ultimate load or crush load divided by area. Ultimate load or crush load divided by area. This is the maximum load. Okay. Above the load, the system will fail. Working stress. What is working stress? Safe load or working load by area. Safe load or working load per area. How to select the factor of safety? How to select the factor of safety? The magnitude of actual load may vary considerably from the estimated value. So, variation in the material properties such as yield strength or ultimate strength also vary. Types of loadings, steady, dynamic, variable, which may occur in service will also vary. So, the number of assumptions made to simplify design calculation may not be exactly valid in actual working conditions. So, while selecting the factor of safety, நம்ம என்ன பண்ணணும் அப்படின்னா, லோடோட ஆக்சுவல் லோடோட மேக்னிட்யூடு பார்க்கணும். ஓகே, அது எப்படி எஸ்டிமேட்டட் வேல்யூவில் வேரி ஆகுதுன்றதை பார்க்கணும். மெட்டீரியல் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டிஸ் வேரியேஷன்ஸ் பார்க்கணும். லோடிங்ஸில் ஏதாவது சர்வீஸில் இருக்கும்போது லோடிங்ஸில் என்ன வேரியேஷன்ஸ் வருதுன்னு பார்த்துட்டு வி ஹவ் டு செலக்ட் த ஃபேக்டர் ஆஃப் சேஃப்டி. ஸோ வாட் இஸ் த லோட் ஃபேக்டர்? லோட் ஃபேக்டர் இஸ் த ரேஷியோ ஆஃப் அல்டிமேட் லோட் டு த ஒர்க்கிங் லோட். அல்டிமேட் லோட் டு த ஒர்க்கிங் லோட், திஸ் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் லோட் ஃபேக்டர். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் மாடுலஸ் ஆஃப் ரிஜிடிட்டி ஆர் சியர் மாடுலஸ். த ரேஷியோ ஆஃப் சியர் ஸ்ட்ரெஸ் டு சியர் ஸ்ட்ரெயின் வித்தின் எலாஸ்டிக் லிமிட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் ஷியர் மாடுலஸ். ஸோ ஷியர் மாடுலஸ் ஆர் மாடுலஸ் ஆஃப் ரிஜிடிட்டி என்ன அப்படின்னா, சியர் ஸ்ட்ரெஸ்ஸுக்கும் சியர் ஸ்ட்ரெயினுக்கும் உள்ள ரேஷியோ. அதான் என்ன சொல்கிறோம், மாடுலஸ் ஆஃப் ரிஜிடிட்டி. நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் ஸ்ட்ரெயின். லீனியர் ஸ்ட்ரெயின் ஆர் லாஞ்சிடியூடினல் ஸ்ட்ரெயின் தென் லேட்ரல் ஸ்ட்ரெயின். வாட் இஸ் லீனியர் ஸ்ட்ரெயின்? லீனியர் ஸ்ட்ரெயின் இஸ் டிஃபைன்ட் அஸ் த ரேஷியோ ஆஃப் சேஞ்ச் இன் லென்த் டு ஒரிஜினல் லென்த். சேஞ்ச் இன் லென்த் டு ஒரிஜினல் லென்த். லேட்ரல் ஸ்ட்ரெயின் அப்படின்னு என்ன சொல்கிறோம் அப்படின்னா, ரேஷியோ ஆஃப் சேஞ்ச் இன் லேட்ரல் டைமென்ஷன் டு ஒரிஜினல் லேட்ரல் டைமென்ஷன். சேஞ்ச் இன் ஒரிஜினல், சேஞ்ச் இன் லேட்ரல் டைமென்ஷன் டு த ஒரிஜினல் லேட்ரல் டைமென்ஷன். நெக்ஸ்ட் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் டேர்ம் இஸ் பாய்சன்ஸ் ரேஷியோ. பாய்சன்ஸ் ரேஷியோ இஸ் த ரேஷியோ ஆஃப் லேட்ரல் ஸ்ட்ரெயின் டு த லாஞ்சிடியூடினல் ஸ்ட்ரெயின். லேட்ரல் ஸ்ட்ரெயின் டு த லாஞ்சிடியூடினல் ஸ்ட்ரெயின். பாய்சன் ரேஷியோவை என்ன பண்ணுறோம் அப்படின்னா, எப்போவுமே 1/m அப்படின்ற டேர்ம்னால தான் நம்ம வந்து டிசைனேட் பண்ணுறோம். வி ஆர் டினோட்டிங் த பாய்சன்ஸ் ரேஷியோ யூசிங் த சிம்பல் 1/m. நெக்ஸ்ட் கம்ஸ் வால்யூமெட்ரிக் ஸ்ட்ரெயின். வாட் இஸ் வால்யூமெட்ரிக் ஸ்ட்ரெயின்? வால்யூமெட்ரிக் ஸ்ட்ரெயின் இஸ் த ரேஷியோ ஆஃப் சேஞ்ச் இன் வால்யூம் டு த ஒரிஜினல் வால்யூம். திஸ் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் வால்யூமெட்ரிக் ஸ்ட்ரெயின். தென் அனதர் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் டேர்ம் இஸ் பல்க் மாடுலஸ். வாட் இஸ் பல்க் மாடுலஸ்? bulk modulus is the ratio of direct stress to the volumetric strain, direct stress to the volumetric strain. Hence, bulk modulus is given by K, it is always denoted by K, and K is given by K is equal to direct stress by volumetric strain. So, this is the relationship between all three elastic constants, okay, E and N and K. Young's modulus, 1 by M is the Poisson ratio, K is the bulk modulus, N is the shear modulus. E is the Young's modulus, N is the shear modulus, K is the bulk modulus, and 1 by M is the Poisson ratio. These are some of the relationships. E is equal to 2N into 1 plus 1 by M, E is equal to 3K into 1 minus 2 into 1 by M, E is equal to 9KN divided by 3K plus N. So, by using these formulas, we can easily determine the values for Young's modulus, shear modulus, bulk modulus, Poisson's ratio. Next is the composite bar. What is a composite bar? A composite bar is defined as the bar made up of two or more different materials joined together in a such a manner that the system extends or contracts as a whole equally when subjected to axial push or pull. Okay. We are going to have an object made out of two materials, material 1, material 2, but when the object is subjected to an axial pulls or axial pushes, it should behave similarly on both the materials. This bar is called as composite bar. In the composite bar na enna appadina oru bar rendu alladhu adarku merpatta material onnukonnu join panni nama senjirrom appo idhula edha load apply pannum boludhu ellame uniform ah behave pannum ella uniform ah extend aanala uniform ah extend aagum compress aanalum uniform ah extend compress aagum. This bar is called as a composite bar. இதில் என்ன, வாட் இஸ் த அட்வான்டேஜ் ஆஃப் த சிஸ்டம் அப்படின்னு பார்த்தோம்னா, விச் மெட்டீரியல் இஸ் ஹேவிங் த பெஸ்ட் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி, ஓகே, தட் வில் பி இம்ப்ளிமெண்டட் இன் த பாடி. அந்த ஆப்ஜெக்ட் இந்த காம்போசிட் பாரில் எப்படி ப்ரொபோர்ஷன்ஸ் மிக்ஸ் பண்ணுறோம் அப்படின்னா, எந்த ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி தேவையோ அது அதிகமாக உள்ள மெட்டீரியல்ஸை வந்து நம்ம மேக்ஸிமமாக மிக்ஸ் பண்ணிக்கிறோம். ஓகே, நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் த டெம்பரேச்சர் ஸ்ட்ரெஸ். த ஸ்ட்ரெஸ் இன் த பாடி டியூ டு சேஞ்ச் இன் டெம்பரேச்சர் இஸ் நோன் அஸ் temperature or thermal stress. We are having a body, maybe it is a boiler or a heat drum like that, okay. So, inge vandhu enna pandromna, we are varying the temperature from time to time. Time to time enna pannit irukkomna, temperature vary pannum poludhu, the body is subjected to some stress. That stress is called as temperature stress. Next one is strain energy. The work absorbed by the material within the elastic limit is called as strain energy. The work absorbed by the material within the elastic limit is called as strain energy. It can be converted into a useful energy. Next comes proof resilience and the modulus of resilience. The maximum strain energy which can be stored in a bar without permanent deformation is called as proof resilience, and the maximum strain energy which can be stored in a bar per unit volume is called as modulus of resilience. It's called as modulus of resilience. So, with this we are coming to the end of this session. In this session, we discussed briefly about the important terminologies related to the mechanical properties of materials. This will be very much useful in due course of the time. So, we will meet in the next session. Thank you.